It's a well-known fact that glucocorticoids as prednisolone or dexamethasone are widely used in hematology in treatment of lymphoproliferative tumors, as chronic lymphocytic leukemia or multiple myeloma, because they decrease lymphocyte count. They decrease lymphocyte count by activation of intrinsic apoptotic pathway. Recall that generally there are two apoptotic pathways. It's extrinsic apoptotic pathway and intrinsic apoptotic pathway. Extrinsic apoptotic pathway is activated when ligands as tumor necrosis factor bind to the cellular receptor that is located on the outer cellular membrane, and this initiates extrinsic apoptotic pathway. However, recall that glucocorticoids are lipophilic molecules that can easily cross cellular membrane, and in the cell they are going into the nucleus where they stimulate or inhibit expression of a certain genes. And one of such genes in the lymphocytes encode BIM proapoptotic protein. The concept is that in the nucleus of the lymphocyte, glucocorticoids cause transactivation of BIM proapoptotic protein, and with transactivation, the expression of BIM proapoptotic protein increases. Basically, we can say that the amount of BIM proapoptotic protein inside the cell increases, and it's the initial event in glucocorticoid-induced apoptosis. So let's take, for example, dexamethasone. Dexamethasone acts on the nucleus of the lymphocyte and increases the expression of BIM proapoptotic protein, and this causes activation of BAC and BAX proapoptotic proteins, and in activated state, BAC and BAX proteins initiate mitochondrial outer membrane permeabilization. So to explain this, we have to know that we have so-called BCL2 family of proteins. They're called like this because they have BCL2 homology domains, so-called BH domains. And this family of proteins is divided into groups, proapoptotic and antiapoptotic proteins. All antiapoptotic proteins have 4 BH domains. All proapoptotic proteins have less than 4 BH domains. Moreover, the quantity of BH domains in proapoptotic proteins is different. According to that principle, proapoptotic proteins are divided into multi-BH domain proapoptotic proteins that have 3 BH domains, its BAC and BAX proteins. The second group is much larger group of proapoptotic proteins, and all these proteins have only one BH domain. Because of that, this group called BH3 only proteins, and this group is divided on activators and sensitizers, and BIM protein belongs to activators group. The major concept here is that multi-domain proteins as BAC and BAX are the central effectors of the apoptosis. Once they are activated, they undergo conformational changes, oligomerize, and form pore in outer mitochondrial membrane. And in normal condition, outer mitochondrial membrane is impermeable. Obviously, if pore is formed, then permeability of the membrane increases, and exactly this phenomenon called mitochondrial outer membrane permeabilization. And as we'll see further, mitochondrial outer membrane permeabilization leads to a cellular apoptosis. So we can say that once multi-domain proteins as BAC and BAX are activated, they kill mitochondria directly and thereby they directly induce apoptosis. In contrast to them, BH3 only proteins cannot kill mitochondria directly, but they can help multi-domain apoptotic proteins to do it. BH3 only proteins can either bind to multi-domain proteins and by this binding they activate them, so they can directly stimulate them to kill mitochondria, and because of that, such proteins called activators, or they can help them indirectly by inactivation of antiapoptotic proteins. And obviously, once they neutralize inhibitors of BAX and BAC proteins, the activity of multi-domain proapoptotic proteins tremendously increases. So it's their indirect stimulation and this group called sensitizers. And as we see, BIM protein belongs to activators group. So once the activity of BIM protein increases, this causes stimulation of multi-domain BAC and BAX proteins. They form pore in outer mitochondrial membrane, or we can say they induce mitochondrial outer membrane permeabilization. And mitochondrial outer membrane permeabilization is the central and the most crucial event in the intrinsic apoptotic pathway. The reason is that with extreme increase in the permeability of the mitochondrial outer membrane, the content from mitochondrial intermembrane space is released into the cytosol. Primarily, it's cytochrome C, apoptosis-inducing factors, and inhibitors of apoptosis proteins antagonists. The major player here is cytochrome C. Cytochrome C induces activation of caspases, and caspases cause severe structural damage to the lymphocyte that leads to a lymphocyte death. To explain this, once cytochrome C is released into the cytosol, cytochrome C initiates a caspase cascade. Cytochrome C binds to apoptotic protease activating factor 1. This complex together with ATP molecule binds to procaspase 9. This results in formation of a massive protein complex called apoptosome. In apoptosome, inactive procaspase 9 is converted to its active form, caspase 9. Caspase 9, called initiator caspase because it activates downstream caspases, its caspase 3, 6, and 7. They called executioner caspases because they have proteolytic activity. They cleave intracellular proteins and by this they cause severe structural damage to them. They affect four major categories of intracellular proteins, its mediators and regulators of apoptosis, structural cellular proteins, cellular DNA repair proteins, and cell cycle related proteins. And we see that all these proteins are of vital importance for the cell, and structural damage to them inevitably leads to a cellular death. Also important to note that caspase proteolytic activity is regulated by specific protein molecules, called inhibitors of apoptosis proteins. The most well-known inhibitor, called X-link inhibitor of apoptosis protein. Basically, they bind to caspases, and by this binding, they markedly decrease their activity. But the second substance that is released from mitochondria are the molecules called inhibitors of apoptosis proteins antagonists. It's MacDiablo and Tommy proteins. They inhibit activity of inhibitors of apoptosis proteins. So basically, they disinhibit caspases, and as we know, caspases in activated state cause cellular death. The third substance that is released into the cytosol is apoptosis-inducing factor. This molecule basically gives signal to the nucleus that the cell is dying, and in response to this, nuclei-induced condensation of chromatin and fragmentation of DNA molecule. So basically, this molecule prepares lymphocytes to death. So as we see, there is a reason why outer mitochondrial membrane in normal condition is practically impermeable. So once again, dexamethasone increases the expression of BIM proapoptotic protein. BIM protein cause activation of multi-domain Buck and Bucks proapoptotic proteins. And in activated state, Buck and Bucks proteins initiate mitochondrial outer membrane permeabilization. Extreme increase in the permeability of the outer mitochondrial membrane leads to release of the mitochondrial content into the cytosol. So from mitochondrial intramembrane space into the cell or cytosol, released cytochrome C, apoptosis-inducing factors, and inhibitors of apoptosis proteins antagonists. Cytochrome C induced activation of caspases, and in addition to this, inhibitors of apoptosis proteins antagonists remove from caspases the inhibitory effect of inhibitors of apoptosis proteins. And in fully activated state, caspases very rapidly cause severe intracellular damage that leads to a lymphocyte death by apoptosis. So it's the mechanism of glucocorticoids induced apoptosis of lymphocytes.